So my wife is having surgery right now and I have to basically cruise around and kill time. So I figured I'd go on a sparkling water run because I'm not down this way very often. All right, so here we go. Let's see what I can freaking find. Okay, first stop on my sparkling water run, Trader Joe's. Dude, I actually have not had any Trader Joe's sparkling water before. So here we go. All right, so I did get some good scores at Trader Joe's. This looks like, so this is like Trader Joe's version of a Spindrift, is what it looks like. Dude, cranberry and lime juice, that's gonna be good. Gotta try the big bottle of the plain. Gotta see how good it is. Bottle does feel pretty tight. I love these little four packs like this. $1.99, this was 99 cents. I don't even remember how much that was. Oh yeah, I did get, no, this is not sparkling. I'm gonna be on the move again. Next stop is gonna be Cost Plus World Market. I love this place, this is gonna be fun. Now here are the finds from Cost Plus. Yeah, I don't know, I was expecting maybe a little bit more diversity, but it's always good though. You never know exactly what they're gonna have. Got some Italian stuff, never had it. No flavor. I'm excited for this, blueberry. It's another Italian one that I have not had. This is an interesting drink. Yes, so you guys know I'm a sparkling water connoisseur. But I also, just beverages in general, I have my whole life actually. In fact, yeah, I'm on Reddit and I'm always posting these beverages I have. But anyway, this is called Cheer Wine, Diet Cheer Wine. No, it's non-alcoholic, but it's like a sparkling cherry drink. I've never had it, I've seen it before and I'm freaking pumped. The Clearly Canadian, absolute classic. I used to drink this when I was a kid. Love it. So yeah, I just got their straight up sparkling water. I actually have one of those at home already, but I want to drink one today and I'm saving one of those for a review video. These are not just sparkling water. These are, they have sugar in it. Freaking great. These were my two favorite flavors when I was a kid. So that's going to be a treat. And then I got this. I just had to. Bubble milk tea. Bubble. So it's going to be like sparkling bubble milk tea. Sounds great. I'll have to bust this open on a video, huh, so you guys can see what I think. Gosh, and I just had to get all this. This is all glass other than that one can that I got, so it's gonna be jingling around in the freaking van. So I got Tazo, I'll secure it. So I got Trader Joe's, I got Cost Plus, and moving on, here we go. This whole area under the bridge here, completely full of homeless people. They got all cleared out because if you're homeless in Oregon, they're gonna put you up in a hotel now. The homeless problem is solved in Oregon now. And why would, if you're homeless, why would you want to come to Oregon? I mean, you're only gonna be put up in a hotel. Is it at the DoubleTree? I doubt it's at the DoubleTree Hill. Yes, I know Target is a bit mainstream, but I gotta pick a couple things up and I'll show you what I'm getting. Okay, so here's what I got at Target. Dude, this stuff is amazing. Right now, this is my favorite caffeinated sparkling water. Just 25 milligrams of caffeine in that sucker there. Only one that Spindrift makes caffeinated. Black Cherry Waterloo is really good. I got grape the other day. Not good, not good at all. Now, this here is, this is Target's brand. I've had it before, it's been a while and I don't remember what one I had. Cranberry citrus sounded pretty good to me. Years ago, Jones Soda, you know, Jones Soda in the bottles, finally came out with cans distributed by Target. It was like a Target exclusive. It might even have said Target exclusive. I think eventually you could find them in a couple more places, but they just went away because it didn't taste the same out of a bottle. Drinking out of a bottle is the best. And then real quick, okay, yeah, yeah, whatever. It's the only caffeinated one I could find. I'm a candy guy too, and so look at that gum. Simply Gum Cleanse, looks like grapefruit. I'm down. These here, I don't know if you guys have ever seen these. These are like diet gummies. That's what they're, look at that, 13 grams of fiber in it. Does have 3 grams of sugar. They're all a little bit different. I've never had this flavor. These are very hit and miss. The gummy bear ones are the best I've had. The peach rings are effing terrible. The Swedish fish ones are terrible. I don't like regular Swedish fish anyway. All right, the beat goes on. Next stop. Continue on to Roth's. Dude, Roth's IGA, it's a Oregon staple. Can you guys see that? That taco time? Man, I'm a big fan of taco time. I know it's not healthy, but I might just have to do that. I'm not over here very often. crisp burritos, apple empanadas. Oh my goodness. It's expensive though. Here we are, Roth's. Let's see what I can find. All right, let me show you what I found at Roth's. First off, you can't go wrong with Topo Chico, obviously, but this is the big boy, the 750 milliliter one. It's like wine. It's like a wine bottle. Look at that. I was actually telling my wife the other night, no joke, I was like, oh, we need to get like a little wine rack and I'll put these in there. Crystal Geyser, I know I was talking about this stuff just a little bit ago. They didn't have a huge selection, but I went with orange. Oh, $1.99 for four. They're 18 ounces too. They're not a 12. Now, something special here. The Citrus House Blood Orange. It's going to be like a Spindrift. 12% juice, just 3 grams of sugar. You know what? I should know the origin of this. Okay, yeah, it's American. Then, because I'm not just a sparkling water guy, oh, I didn't even notice it was CBD. Oh, well, whatever. I don't know. I guess we'll see how it is. I'm having a blast doing this. I got all my glass stuff wrapped up in those blankets right there. I'm going to cruise around. I have a little bit more time to kill. We'll see. I'm on the go and I got to take a crap, which is always really fun. And I'm like, oh, I'll go to the Sandwich Express and I'll go in and use the restroom. Well, I get there. And nope, the lobby's closed. I was even an idiot. I went all the way up to the door. I gotta find a place. I don't know why I'm letting you guys know this. I'm just bored. I'm cruising around. Well, things are getting not so boring here pretty soon. Gotta go to the bathroom, and this is where I'm going. Might as well see what they have for sparkling water too, so kill two birds with one stone, right? So I actually found some stuff at Fred Meyer. Arrowhead is great overall, but it's really, really good. It's a plastic bottle, but it's just really carbonated. I've always liked it. I've never had this, and they had lots of flavors. I went tangerine, lemongrass. God, I thought it said lemonade in there. That's fine, lemongrass is fine. I'm a little dyslexic, I read fast and I don't always read the whole word. I just kind of put it together and come up with something. And now I was looking here, this is Kroger, which would be the Fred Meyer brand. So this is everything I got. Got the stuff I got at Roth's there, Target there. This stuff was all Trader Joe's right there. And then all the glass, the big glass that I got at Cost Plus World Market is wrapped up there. So yeah, Target, Cost Plus, Roth's. And oh yeah, I didn't get a bag of Trader Joe's. All right, so there we go. Thank you for joining me on the sparkling water run.
You wanna tell them what we got?
Oh,